Hi guys, मैं हूँ काम्या जानी, the chief traveling officer at Curly Tales, and as a part of my job, I travel around the globe. हो सकता है आपने मेरे न्यूजीलैंड के वीडियोस भी देखे हो, because some of you actually had a lot of questions about the place. I thought क्यों ना एक वीडियो बनाया जाए जिसमें सारे सवालों के आंसर हो, which includes from planning your trip to all you need to know about the land of kiwis. Let's get started. Let me first tell you a few fun facts about New Zealand. Well, the land size of New Zealand is same as Great Britain or Japan. The population is only about 4.5 million. The official language spoken there is English and Therio Māori. Don't worry, agar aapko Therio Māori nahi aati, yahan pe English sabko samajh mein aati hai. The official currency used there is New Zealand dollar, and one New Zealand dollar is 50 Indian rupees. Also, there are no dangerous animals or snakes there, so you don't need a vaccination. It's got a beautiful landscape. It's also got an excellent tourism infrastructure, and the environment is absolutely clean and unpolluted. Let's get started with planning your trip to New Zealand. But first and foremost, let's talk about visa. All Indians need to have visa and a valid passport to enter into New Zealand, and it's best to plan your trip in a way that you have 30 days to have your visa in place. Online it says about 12 to 15 days, but it's best to have 1 month in hand, and I'm only talking about tourist visa here. The best time to visit New Zealand would be in the summer months, which starts from November going all the way till February. It's not too cold, not too hot, perfectly okay weather. Some of the coldest months in New Zealand are June, July and August. So you can avoid that, but the best time to visit would be the end of the year. Well, if you're traveling in the summer months, you don't need to carry too many jackets, but remember to carry at least a couple of them. Because what summer for New Zealand may be very cold for Indians, and I have personally experienced this. So hamesha apne saath ek jacket ya shawl zarur rakhiye, because there may be few places where it may get very windy or it may rain, and in that case you may feel very cold. However, the average temperature in summer months ranges between 18 to 25 or going up to 30 degrees as well. But in winters, you definitely need to be well geared. And New Zealand is very big on adventure, so remember to carry your sportswear and also your sports shoes. Well, let's now talk about how to get to New Zealand. Well, there are multiple ways in which you can get to New Zealand, but unfortunately, there is no direct flight. And the minimum travel duration that you would need is between 16 to 22 hours. There are flights that go via Malaysia, Singapore, or even Sri Lanka and Australia. So look out for the best and cheapest options online before you book your tickets. As for me, well, I went via Singapore Airlines. I had a halt in Singapore for a couple of hours, and from there I took a flight to Auckland via Air New Zealand. Well, let's now talk about traveling in and around New Zealand. Now, all of New Zealand has been divided into two islands, the North Island and the South Island. Four major places that you definitely need to cover are Auckland, Wellington, Christchurch and Queenstown. And to cover all of these places, you need a minimum of 10 to 15 days at hand to be able to see all of New Zealand. And one of the best ways to get around these cities is, of course, a self-drive. It's one of the best ways to explore the city. The other way to get around New Zealand is domestic flights. They have an extensive domestic air network. All you need to do is book well in advance for the best airfares. However, for more economical and budget options, there are also buses that you can take. Par usme waqt zyada lagta hai, but if you don't mind sparing that kind of time, you can also travel by bus. Let's now get into the details of the itinerary. Well, start your trip from Auckland. Well, Auckland is one of the best places to start your New Zealand journey. You can visit the iconic Sky Tower, walk by the edge to feel the pulse of the city. You can take a ride on a Bullerangi motorbike. And in fact, you can also visit Auckland War Memorial and enjoy a cultural performance by the Maori tribe. You know, Auckland is also called the City of Sails, and you won't believe there are actually more boats in Auckland than people. You can sit by the waterfront and watch the world pass by. Well, once you've explored Auckland, make a trip to the Hobbiton movie set, which is only 2 hours away from Auckland. It's in a region called Matamata. And you know, if you are a true LOTR or a Hobbit fan, trust me, no trip to New Zealand will be complete till you visit this gorgeous movie set. Well, more than the Hobbiton movie set, the drive to the Hobbiton movie set, it's spectacular. You will see beautiful natural landscape all around you. You can now make your way to South Island, and like I mentioned, some of the best places there to visit is Christchurch and Queenstown. What I did was took a connecting flight from Wellington, spent some time in the capital city of New Zealand. It is gorgeous, and after that, we took a connecting flight to Christchurch. From Christchurch, we drove all the way up to Mount Cook, and again, the drive was spectacular. Is the tallest mountain in New Zealand. It is absolutely beautiful, and there are various ways in which you can experience Mount Cook, stay at the Hermitage Hotel, go for a ski plane experience, or even see the glacier as you sail through the water. And now it's time to visit the adventure capital of the world, Queenstown. Queenstown is known for its adventure sports, be it skydiving, bungee jumping, shark diving, all of that. You can do a lot of things here in Queenstown. But there's one experience that I can't forget, and that is to Milford Sound Cruise. We took a bus trip to Milford Sound, which was actually very long. Alternatively, you can take a helicopter ride as well, but it is all dependent on the weather conditions. It was one of the most beautiful experiences. You are surrounded by limestone caves. It's got beautiful scenery all around you. There's cascading waterfalls that you may see, and it's absolutely breathtaking. Let's talk about where to stay. But New Zealand has plenty of options when you talk about accommodation, be it luxury or even budget. There are a whole host of Airbnbs that you can rent out, which turn out to be quite economical. But if you want some luxury, well, there are plenty of options for you as well. New Zealand is known for its food and its culinary delights. When you visit New Zealand, few things that you definitely must try are the Ferg Burger, which you find in Queenstown. You must definitely try the crayfish, which is one of the most popular delicacies in New Zealand. You must try the famous fish and chips. There's also pavlova, Ferg Burger, and the local favorite ice cream, which is the Hokey Pokey ice cream. It's like a softy ice cream which you get in India. It's pretty close to that, but it's got some nice honey crumbs to it. So you must definitely try that. And I know if you're an Indian, you would definitely be curious to know if there are enough Indian restaurants. So don't worry, Indian restaurants bhi wahan pe kahi saare hain. Agar aapko butter chicken aur dal khane ka man kiya, to wahan par aapko wo bhi mil jayega. Don't worry. But I would always encourage all of you to actually try the local food that you get in New Zealand. Well, with that, I think I've covered almost every aspect of visiting New Zealand. But if you may still have questions around it, feel free to ask any questions. Remember, I've done a series of episodes on New Zealand, from how to get there to best things to do to best adventure sports that you must try, all of it. So watch those videos and drop in your comments. And remember to like, share and subscribe to Curly Tales. Until then, it's me, Kamya Jani, signing off.